I'm Haley.
I'm Amanda.
And we're
Haley and Amanda. And you're listening to the Haley and Amanda podcast.
I like that little, I have to say, the little singing thing you do, and then you really added something extra.
I'm feeling extra today, Haley. I don't know about you,
but I'm feeling on sunshine.
I'm feeling on sunshine. I got sunshine in a bag.
I got sunshine.
That's it. Okay. That's what I was thinking. Yeah, which is funny because we just got out of a blizzard.
Well, we just got out of a blizzard and we just got out of a very sunshiny day.
Yeah, so.
Right after a blizzard.
For all you out there, we're in Texas. We're in Dallas, Texas.
You've probably heard of us.
You've heard of us lately in the news.
Yeah, we're bigger.
But not better sometimes. No. We just had a blizzard this week that has been really terrible for a whole lot of folks.
Yep.
And we've all been stuck in our houses again. But this time, even worse for folks because people lost power, frozen pipes. So they lost water, busted pipes. Haley and I, both of our homes did not lose power.
So fortunate.
So grateful. We think, my husband and I think it's because we live right on the same street as the big Methodist hospital. And so it is, we're guessing we're on their power grid because we did not lose power and so many people around us, like further in the neighborhood, did. So we're thinking that's where ours.
Yeah, and I'm honestly not sure about mine. I do have a firehouse that's about half a mile away, but I don't, well, first of all, I don't know how power grids work.
Yeah, I don't either. We're assuming.
Yeah.
But like our families lost power, both of our parents did in the suburbs.
Yep.
And like my parents, yours too.
Yeah,
I mean, lost
days,
water,
days and days.
Power for most of the week. And you guys know I'm a teacher. A lot of my students have been displaced. A lot of my students have lost power. And so we don't even have school Monday and Tuesday, even though the weather's going to be fine, because they're trying to figure out, first of all, busted pipes in the schools. And also our students aren't able to be home right now, which is insane. I mean, it is insane.
It's just like a lot of people have been saying, just like the year that keeps on giving, or like it's one thing after another, or, you know, a lot of phrases like that going around.
Yeah, and it did feel that way this week. I almost feel bad about how fortunate we were, because I was in some pretty nasty group texts of like people dealing with some stuff, and they were like, do you have power? Because we're dying. And I'm like, we do. Yeah. We do.
But like I would have hosted anyone.
Yeah, but everyone,
the roads were so bad too.
Well, and the people that I talked to, their families hosted them.
Yeah.
And then so we didn't end up posting people, even though we offered, because most people went with extended family and things like that. But it was really bad. Whenever I say, I'm born and raised in Texas, I've never seen temperatures this low. I've never seen quite this much snow, to be honest with you.
Yeah, because we've lived in a few other places and traveled to places that the temperatures have been like this, or, you know, the snow has been that bad. But it kind of felt like we were in those places. I just couldn't believe we were in Texas.
Yeah, and luckily, because we had lived in like Oregon before, we had some good winter clothing. And so we took, I mean, we were never together, but we took our dogs separately each day to go walking. And I would get super bundled up and I would feel fine. And I really enjoyed actually being out in the snow, but because we weren't dealing with all the other stuff, you know?
So kind of a strange week. There was some things that we're grateful for and it was okay. But obviously for the entire state, it was
really
something traumatic.
And it's still quite traumatic. People
to
don't have water. Today I donated to Baby to Baby, because, and it was super, super easy, guys. We're going to put the link in today's episode. But they're, what I love about Baby to Baby is that they really focus on families with young children who need like formula, diapers, water for young kid families, mm-hmm. But also like feed Feeding America, which we donated to. Yeah, we donated to them at Christmas. They have like the North Texas Food Bank that is doing a lot of great work. So if you are able to give even anything, they are really appreciative right now because they're doing a lot of work that is very important for families and all types of people, the elderly who are struggling. I mean, honestly, it's such a mess. It brought to light a lot of things about Texas and how efficient we are in certain areas and how inefficient we are mostly in certain areas. And it's just been a really tough week. Yeah. And so thank you for those of you who have kept us in your thoughts and prayers and have been donating. Like, I'm not just us, but I'm saying about Texas in general, because it has been a really hard time for folks. I feel so grateful that I didn't deal with it, but I also feel so bad for the folks around me who did.
Yeah. It's been kind of sweet though, also seeing people posting how to help and like people posting that they just want to host people or that they would do anything for anyone, you know, and we're still unfortunately in the middle of a global pandemic.
Yeah.
So hosting people, you know, it's not something iffy. You shouldn't be doing it, but people were just kind of like, we'll be safe. We'll do what we have to, like, forget it, you know, we'll be safe. But it just was really nice. And I think, you know, we do dog on Texas sometimes, but we got some really good people here, like in our community and in our neighborhoods and our
family. The ones that aren't good, they go to Cancun, and it's just
not a big of a deal. She did it. She went there.
No, but anyways, we really encourage you guys to give where you can, even if you're here in Texas, and maybe you weren't affected as badly, like we weren't. It was kind of my way of feeling because I felt guilty, like I wanted to give to organizations that were doing something
because
I mean, I was trapped in my house, but I knew that these organizations were doing something. So anyways, we'll post in this show notes those organizations that we're supporting that would be good help for you to add to.
But that honestly is why we decided to talk about what we're going to talk about this week.
Yes, because regardless of, yes, we didn't lose power or water. We were trapped in our houses for a week.
It was like the beginning of quarantine again.
I know. My husband and I, we were sitting on the couch on that first day, and I was like, hello, darkness, my old friend. No, it was like, we both said, we know this, code red, let's go. Let's do it. We got this.
I mean, let's go time. Up on food. I mean, we know the recipes.
Feels like the good old days in the first days of quarantine.
Jesus. Well, and I told Amanda and a few of my other friends that somehow I convinced myself that when the blizzard was over, so was COVID.
I did too. Today I told Haley, because this is how crazy Texas is. Well, I want to say global warming is with extreme weather. When I tell you this week has been 19, 14, 1 degrees, 2 negative degrees, two. Negative 2, like super cold. Today it is in the high 50s, so sunny.
We had to
everything
take off
is melted. Whenever we went out today, we had to take off our jackets and beanies because it was so hot.
And we were wearing double layered with snow boots and gloves and our walks yesterday.
Yeah, and today it's so hot. It's so hot and sunny. So it's a complete 180. It's insane. So today though,
we were so excited.
We haven't seen each other in a week, right. And Haley lives alone, and so she went cuckoo ka-choo-coo.
All right. I did.
You did. Can I please say today?
Amanda.
It's so funny. She was going to come over to record the podcast, and I said, hey, listen, before we record, I'm going to take us to go get some food at this really cute place, and I said, come dressed cute, like going out, and I said, and we're going to do that before we record the podcast, and she was like, really? Okay, and she got so excited, and then she starts texting me, should I wear my snow boots, or is that too much? How nice is this place? I gotta tell you right now that I don't know if I should wear jeans or these sweatpants. Okay, wait. Should I wear my North Face jacket or is it not nice enough?
And
I was like,
on the patio.
I was like, Haley, it's it's not a nice place. We're just, it's a lunch spot I'm going to take us to. And she was like, okay, but if you were going to wear a t-shirt, would you wear a sweatshirt over it? And like, I was like, she's totally forgotten how to be a human in the real world.
Yeah.
You did.
I did.
It's okay. It was, you know, cute.
It's a combo of COVID, you know, not letting us go anywhere. And then we started a little bit starting to, and then this just locked us back down. But I haven't seen anyone for a week. And so, and I wore the same clothes every day.
Me too.
I mean, you just,
I wore my
same routine.
My REI sweatpants.
Yeah,
and my Rolling Stones sweatshirt every day this week. Same. I washed it once.
Yep, me too, same. Yeah, except for I wore a paint sweatshirt because I would try to paint sometimes and I didn't want to have to change twice.
Why would you want to do that? And so we...
Oh, I got scared about what to wear.
Well, before we go into what we're talking about this week about being locked down again, I just want to say about our day today. Because it is, yes. It's been a bag of sunshine.
We're walking on sun. Ah! That's how we feel. Burst.
Because, so I took her to lunch at this place I've been dying to go to.
Y'all, we need to post about this place.
Oh my gosh. It's called Fount Board and Table, which I know them from the wedding industry. They do gorgeous charcuterie boards for events. But they have a brick and mortar store in Uptown Dallas that has unbelievable food and the cutest ambiance. And so we went outside there on their patio and got this amazing spread. Like, we overdid it. We got a charcuterie board, sandwich, salad, soup.
I got this homemade latte. She got this lavender matcha homemade.
Oh my gosh. Everything, like, literally, there wasn't one thing where we were like, this is just okay. It was like, what? Like, best ingredients, super fresh, super
so
delicious,
beautiful.
Gorgeous ambiance, and we were screaming.
It's what we needed so badly, because all we've done is, like, watch beautiful shows all week.
I know. And then the waitress, she was like, y'all are bringing so much positive energy, because every time they brought something out, we were like, you guys! No! So perfect! And they were like, we really needed you guys to... We needed them.
So please, you've got to go there.
You
got
to go there.
Fount Board and Table.
Yes. So we, and if anything, just follow their Instagram. It is
gorgeous. Yeah, if you're
not in Texas. Their Instagram's gorgeous. Anyways, so we leave there, we come home, grab the pepperonis, and we go.
That's Haley and Amanda slang for
dogs.
Yeah.
So we go for a walk down in our neighborhood, a long walk. We go shopping.
Yes, we go shopping.
We bought some new masks. We went to this gorgeous vintage shop.
And on the way out of Fount Board and Table, we decided we needed some drinks for the road. So we got some.
We were acting like we were the queens of Thailand.
And took them on our walk.
We went to this new vintage shop.
My gosh.
We bought vintage blazers and this vest she's wearing. We bought Maude and Joe earrings. We were just living the life.
Could not help
out
herself.
In the sunshine, and it felt like COVID was over.
Yeah,
it's
she
not.
She was like, Haley, I want you to know that if it's beautiful inside of there, I'm eating inside.
And she was like, no, you're not. And
I was like, dang it, tempt me.
So we ate on the porch. But guys, I'm just telling you, it was so great to leave our house and be around the living. You know, it was just really nice. We saw some people who were like, did you guys lose power? And they're like, yeah. Some of them were like, no.
Everyone's so happy to see
everyone.
Everyone's
so happy to be out. And so, yeah, we're celebrating today.
We really, I'm having such a great day.
I've never been so happy.
I know. I think maybe we just need a blizzard every now and then.
When everything's stripped away from you, you realize you're happy with a vintage shop and some earrings and a nice meal. You really like
it.
So we had a really fun day, and we're so happy that life feels a little... I felt normal today.
I did. I did too.
And it just made me so pleased with everything, and and just wanted to scream out loud.
I want some ice cream.
Yeah. So what we're talking about today, though, is it's okay to not be productive. And we're talking about that because...
We were talking about our week.
Yes. And if you're a type of person or personality who's kind of like a go, go, go.
Hustler.
Hustler. We've talked about our Enneagrams before. I'm a type 3, which is called the Achiever. Haley is the type 7, which is the
Enthusiast. I don't want to miss out on anything.
Yes, and so we're a good match, and we're also a terrible match for being snowed in and shut down from a pandemic.
Because we are after the good life.
And the good life's hard to find trapped in your house. So we, those being our personalities, and if that's a type of personality you have, even, and it's more than just 3 and 7. I mean, there's other personalities that are, like, you want to be working towards something, you want to be creating, you want to be making, you want to be moving forward. And it's just really hard when you're trapped in your house and everything's shut down, right? This is something that we've dealt with all year through this pandemic. And so Haley and I were kind of talking about that this week, about how we had no energy to do anything. It was like we were in hibernation.
Well, and what's strange is that it's backwards, because you have all the time.
You're off work.
Yep. I work out in my studios in my house. I could have painted 100 paintings in the past week. I could have caught up.
Well, through pandemic.
I could have caught up on everything I ever wanted to do.
I know. I mean, I could have organized every drawer like Lisa told me to.
And you
didn't touch a thing.
Yeah, and like books. I've got a stack of books halfway through.
I've got a stack of books.
I mean,
I also just wanted to, like, you know, do some self-care even.
Yeah, paint my toenails.
Yeah, I wanted to take care of myself, and I wanted to do things around the house. And I told Michael at the beginning of this, Maris, I told him at the beginning of this, I said, listen, we're going to tackle our guest room closet, okay? Because I want to organize it hardcore. And he was like, I'm in.
We've got the time.
We've got the time. And every day I'd be like, you want to go work on that? And he's like, nah. And I'm like, me either. You know, it was just like, why? We have all this time. And we didn't lose power. We didn't lose water like other people who were kind of like fighting to survive. And
so we're just kind of talking about
why.
Why, when you have the time and you have the space and you're technically on the outside, you're okay. You know, like, we're healthy. This week we had power and stuff. Why does it feel like you're paralyzed?
Well, and also, I had zero energy to, like, work out. I thought,
Oh my God. I counted my walk with sugar.
Me too. But then that was like the only time I moved in the day, so it couldn't have been exercise. Yeah. But I was like, Amanda, you're inside. Why don't you do, like, an indoor workout on
some
the TV?
Yoga. Some your yoga. Body hurts.
Yes. Nothing. Mm-mm. Not even kind of.
But at least we ate healthy all week.
Girl. I was eating frozen pizzas, Velveeta shells.
Pasta.
I was eating some bad chocolate-covered strawberries from Valentine's.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I mean.
So let's talk about
why you'd lose that energy.
Yeah, and it was right at the beginning, actually, of this week, this crazy week, that Maris introduced Amanda to this stand-up, Tom Papa, and guess what it's called?
You're Doing Great.
You're Doing Great.
It's on Netflix. Highly recommend it. He's so funny. But his whole thing is that humans are going through so much, and we're doing great.
You're just fine.
Just give yourself a pat on the back. You're surviving. You're making it. You're doing great.
Fine. Yeah, you're a little chubbier than you want to be.
He said, hey, we're all fat right now. And it's you're either really fat, kind of fat, or trying not to be fat. But fat's coming. And he's like, and you're great. He was like, you know what? We still like the way you look. And we guarantee it. He's like, you're great. You're doing fine.
He's like, oh, you're mad you don't have the body of an Olympic athlete?
You're not an Olympic athlete. You're Dawn from Sales. We like you. And I just loved the whole stand-up.
It was so positive, because
it's like you're comparing yourself to all these other people and all these other things, and you're just you, and you're doing great. We're going through some hard stuff. Yeah. You're making it just fine.
And it's like, the last thing we need, on top of having a not productive week, is to beat ourselves up about it.
I know, because it's
the week's gone.
It's so easy to. Like, all week I was kind of like, Amanda, you freaking lazy woman. Like, get up and do an ab workout. And then I was like, No, one more episode of The Lost Kitchen.
Oh, I watched that 3 times.
Yeah, so it's okay that we haven't been productive. Don't beat yourself up about it. You're in a global pandemic. You're in a blizzard in Texas, maybe. Other states are dealing with the blizzard,
totally.
Too.
Well, and it's just, I mean, we don't realize, because we were really talking about why. Like, why is it? And it has something to do with, and what's buzzing kind of in the background for all of us is this, like, trauma that's happening to us. And we don't want to use those words. We don't want to admit to it. But we are
in a trauma.
We are all going through for, look at the clock, a year is about to
next
be
month.
A year, yep. Of this trauma of, you know, our world just being overturned. And then, that's the pandemic. But we also have other things going on. You still have stuff with your relationships. You still have regular health stuff.
And then on top of the pandemic, we had this blizzard shutdown and snowstorms, and businesses are struggling. And our friend sent us this article. Is it from the New York Times?
It's actually from The Guardian. I misremembered. But our friend Lisa sent it to us at the beginning of the pandemic because we were having these same conversations. Like,
not achieving enough.
We got all this time. Oh, I'm just going to take care of everything I ever wanted to do since we have to be locked in. And then everyone's like, I can't do anything. I can't make anything.
It's like you're paralyzed.
Yes.
So read the part of this article that, because we were remembering it this week, the same feelings.
We can also put the link to this article in because I'm just going to read a paragraph. But the whole article is really insightful, a fresh perspective on like what we're all going through. It says, as the pandemic upended our lives, people around me worried that they were having trouble focusing and being productive. It was, I suspected, because we were all doing other, more important work. When you're recovering from an illness, pregnant or young and undergoing a growth spurt, you're working all the time, especially when it appears that you're doing nothing. Your body is growing, healing, making, transforming, and laboring below the threshold of consciousness. As we struggled to learn the science and statistics of this terrible scourge, our psyches were doing something equivalent. We were adjusting to the profound social and economic changes, studying the lessons disasters teach. Equipping ourselves for an unanticipated world.
And to me, that speaks volumes about what we've all been dealing with this year. That, okay, yes, we might have been sitting in a moment of stillness, like physical stillness, but what's buzzing in our psyches, like what Haley was saying, kind of like in this background, the anxieties of the unknown, all the trauma that comes with change like this, being worried about your family if you have young kids, worried about your business, worried about your own health and not dying from this, you know, virus. I mean, and then especially now on top of it, this winter storm, that's become like survival mode for people as well. And so all of that is really big stuff. I saw a tweet the other day, I don't remember who it was from, but it was like, she says to her, or it was like a quote that said, I wonder why I'm feeling anxious for no reason, she says to herself as she sits among a global pandemic and a total economic shutdown. Or like, it was just, you might feel like, I'm fine, nothing's like, my world's okay, but there's so much happening in the background.
Yeah, and it's like anxiety in the background buzzing, but that anxiety, if you try to look at it like in a positive way, like this article is about, it's because we are amazingly adaptive people.
And resilient.
Yes, and our psyches are trying to figure out how we're going to change and cope and adapt.
And learn from this.
And we're going to get out of it. And we're creating new solutions to how to be in this world. So when we're sitting numb, dumb on the couch, and we're like, oh man, I didn't do anything. I didn't do a workout. Well, that's okay.
You've been doing mental gymnastics all day.
For real.
It's so true. I love that perspective.
Yeah.
It's so positive that you're trying to cope. You're trying to forward think. You're making your world work in this new environment, and it is exhausting.
Yes.
And it seems like it shouldn't be because it's not physical, but the truth is it is exhausting, and you're doing a lot more than you think you are with coping. And it's not like some cop-out to be like, cool, I'm lazy now. I don't do anything all day. You're doing a lot. And this is a period of time. You don't have to be achieving all the time. You don't have to be productive all the time. You're being productive in different ways.
Yeah, and it's not to say that, you know, I get spurts of, and we do together, we get spurts of like energy and ideas, and we want to tackle some big thing, and we do.
Even through the pandemic we did.
Yes, of course. But all we're trying to say is like, when you feel those spurts, go after them. But if you're in a moment where you're in a lull and you're feeling like, can't do anything and I don't understand why, don't beat yourself up about
it. Don't fight it.
You're doing great. You're fine.
We still like you. You're done from sales. No, it's true. It's this, you know, delicate balance of giving yourself grace, but also totally realizing that this is really unprecedented times for us. You know, even my father, you know, this is the funny thing. My 5-year-old niece left their house. This was kind of at the beginning of the pandemic, and was like, you know, Granddad, this is my first quarantine. And he's like, mine too. You know, like it's new for all of us. And it's funny, the kids, like, it's kind of all they know. Mm-hmm. Like my niece, she's turning 1 next week. And so she was literally born mm-hmm. a couple of weeks before the shutdown. So this is all this is what she knows, but that she has been loved through it by her family and stuff. It's the you know, you just realize what's important.
Yep.
And also that it's okay to feel this kind of sluggishness and this kind of going into like a hibernating stage, because we're doing great.
Yeah, I mean, it makes me want to just pat everyone on the back, honestly. I mean, we just were on a walk and we saw some of our friends with their kids, and they're out, and you know, they've kept them home from school for safety this entire year. They both work, you know, and it's like,
you guys are superheroes.
You are doing so great. Like, you have rose to the occasion, and I bet that they, if you talk to them, they would be like, man, we feel like we're just barely hanging on, you know? And it's like, oh my God, we are such wonderful humans. Like, this has pushed us to our limits, and it's really kind of crushed a lot of things inside of us. But at the same time, almost like a mirror, it has, like you're saying, made us realize what's important. And we really have rose to the occasion.
Right.
You know? So it's okay if we don't feel like we're a superhero every day, you know?
Because we're not going to feel like that all the time.
So we are here to tell you, you're doing great.
We're doing great. We're going to make it.
You're fine.
And one of the things that I had told Maris on a walk earlier in the pandemic is that, because I've told you guys, I deal with anxieties and things like that. And sister does. That's why she barks all the time. But I was kind of, when this first hit, I was kind of like, oh gosh, is this going to bring up a lot of like panic and anxiousness within myself? And, you know, I realized like, I am resilient and I can adapt, and we all can. One of the most amazing things about this year has been like seeing businesses rise to the occasion to change
and be creative.
Yes, and be creative to make what they do work in this new situation that we find ourselves in. And to me, those are the real leaders in business. Those people who have chosen to redesign and make it work and figure it out. Like, those are the people who are gonna make it. They're gonna make it because they're changing, and sometimes change hurts and it's uncomfortable, but it's just like the article, like the lessons you learn from disasters and in tragedy are some of the greatest lessons, because it shows you that you can make it work. You are resilient, you are strong, you can make whatever comes at you work for you.
And not to like belabor this topic, but that show, The Lost Kitchen, that we keep talking about on Discovery Plus, she has come up with the most creative ideas for how to make it through as a small business restaurant.
But so have so many small businesses here in our neighborhoods where they've gone to drive-ups, takeouts, like they change everything and they're adapting.
But
and
it is literally because we're going through a disaster. Otherwise,
you would have never, the same stuff you're doing.
You would have never explored anything else because you have to reach a crossroad in your life where things have to be questioned. Mm-hmm. And often we don't do it to ourselves because we're comfortable. Everything's fine, it's working, it's easy, so nothing really grows or changes. And so, I mean, as much as I hate what's happening, you know, both things that we've been talking about today, it is, again, just showing how resilient and creative and stretchy that we can be through disaster. And you're doing great.
You're doing great.
You're fine.
And honestly, for me, I have been so proud of the way people have come together through this time. I know that there has been a lot of division in our country and a lot through this election that happened during the pandemic. That's why it feels like one thing after another this year. It's like
been a lot to handle.
A lot of civil unrest, a lot of, you know, racial injustice, a lot of political separation and division, and then on top of it are the economy. It's just, you know, you pack it on one after the other, and you look at this year and think, oh my gosh, what did we go through? You know what I mean? But also, we've gone through it.
Yeah, we're going through it.
We're going through it. And we got out from it. And we're working towards the future to make it better, to be better for the future. And so, you know, whenever I sit there on the couch and I'm feeling bad about maybe how not productive I'm being, or I feel bad about how lazy I feel, I have to remind myself, Amanda, you're doing so much right now. It's okay to sit here on the couch and chill for a minute. You know, it's okay that you're so stressed about so many things, about your parents losing power and your brother's family, and like you can't do anything and you're just sitting there, and it's like, no wonder I'm exhausted.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? It's not the time right now for you to go organize your drawers. You need to sit down and watch some Discovery Plus, girl.
I mean, if you've got it in you to do it,
go
for it. But if you don't beat yourself up about it.
Don't beat yourself up, guys. You're doing fine. You're doing great. We love you.
And you know, I was trying to think of a transition into our pledge.
Oh, yeah.
But there it is.
Our transition to our pledge?
You always have these two united mates.
You do.
You got us.
You got us. We're going through this together. We're going to make it. We're going to be resilient.
One day we're going to be more in public, not rarely in public.
And we're going to have not just our friendship under God.
We're going to have all of your friendships. It'll be just all of us.
Just us with all of you. Okay, here we go.
We're going to be living pretty.
You better put your hand over your heart, Yale. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United Mates in America, and rarely in public is where we stand. One friendship under God, indivisible, live pretty. You better do it. And just us for all. That's right. It's just us for all. Thank you guys so much for supporting us. Remember to donate if you can to the organizations like Baby to Baby, Feeding America, North Texas Food Bank. We're going to put all of this in our notes. We hope you guys are staying safe, staying warm, staying
happy,
watered, happy. If you have any other organizations that you know about that are really doing great work that we can post about so that people can donate to, please let us know. And we will see you guys next week. Until then,
live pretty.
Bye.